Hello, I'm Professor Von Schmohawk, and welcome to Why You. In the previous lecture, we saw a race between a tortoise and a hare. Although the hare decided to spend the first 4 hours of the race reading a chapter in his algebra book, he soon caught up with the tortoise. Graphing their distances from the starting point as functions of time, we saw that the tortoise and hare each traveled at constant speeds, the tortoise starting first, followed 4 hours later by the hare. Since the hare's speed was greater than the tortoise's, once he started, he quickly caught up, eventually passing the tortoise sometime between 5 and 6 hours after the race had begun. At the end of the lecture, we derived equations for these graphs. In this lecture, we will see how to use these equations to mathematically determine the coordinates of their intersection point, and thus the exact time and distance when the tortoise and hare meet. There are several different mathematical methods which can be used to find the points of intersection of two graphs. In this lecture, we will demonstrate a method called substitution. We know that the coordinates of any point on an equation's graph represent one possible solution to the equation. So the set of all points which make up the graph represents every possible solution to the equation. Likewise, for a different equation, the set of all the points which make up that graph represents every possible solution to that equation. Any point which lies on both graphs therefore represents a solution to both equations. We can find this intersection point if we find values for x and y which simultaneously satisfy both equations. Each equation tells us something about the relationship between x and y. For example, the second equation tells us that the value of y must be equal to 1/2 the value of x. Since we know that the value of y must be 1/2 x, we can substitute 1/2 x for y in the first equation. This gives us an equation with a single variable x. We can then solve this equation to find the value of x. Multiplying both sides by 2, on the left, we get 2 times 1/2 x, or x. And on the right, distributing the 2 to the terms in parentheses, we get 2 times 2x, or 4x, minus 2 times 8, or 16. Adding 16 to both sides, and subtracting x from both sides, we get 16 equals 4x minus x, or 16 equals 3x. Finally, dividing both sides by 3 gives us 16/3 equals x, or x equals 16/3. Now that we know the value of x, we can set the value of x in either equation to 16/3. And find the corresponding value of y. Either equation will give us the same answer, so since the second equation is the simplest, we will use it to find the value of y. Setting x to 16/3, we see that y is 1/2 times 16/3, or 8/3. We can check our calculated values for x and y by substituting them for x and y in the original equations and verifying that they create true statements. So the values of x and y which satisfy both equations are 16/3 and 8/3. These are the values of the x and y coordinates of the intersection point of the two graphs. Converting these fractions to mixed numbers, we see that this point represents an elapsed time of 5 1/3 hours, and a distance of 2 2/3 miles from the starting point. So 5 hours and 20 minutes after the race has begun, the tortoise and hare meet 2 2/3 miles from the starting point. This method of solving a system of equations is called substitution. This name is appropriate, since as we saw in this example, the value of y, represented in terms of x in one equation, is substituted for the variable y in a second equation. Since only the variable x remains in that equation, it can then be solved to find a unique value for x, which can then be substituted back into either equation to find a unique value for y. In the next lecture, we will introduce a second method of solving systems of equations called elimination.